everybody. Welcome back to Aviary Attorney. We're starting 4B.
4B.
This is the last one for us, but it's the second one for you.
Yeah. Oh, man. You kicked so much derriere at that impromptu trial yesterday. Those rebels were all like, we're executing this punk. Mob justice, rah, rah, rah. But you were all like, this isn't how we do things in France, chicken pluckers. And then they were all like,
Sparrow Sen, let's get serious for a moment.
Serious? You just pulled off the craziest lawyering move in the history of French law. We should be celebrating.
We don't have time to pull out the champagne.
I'm just looking at her right over Sparrowson's eye.
What are you doing, weirdo? Didn't you see the anger in the rebels' eyes? Didn't you feel the tension in the air? We're just days away from violence breaking out into the streets.
I'm panting.
Yeah, Kim Cheese. We just took him outside.
Oh yeah, I guess another revolution might be around the corner. But what exactly can we do? We already told the police everything we know. Unless you're not thinking of arming yourself to the teeth and fighting the rebel forces yourself, are you?
What? No, you watch far too many action operas. I was thinking of preparing a legal case.
A case? For whom?
At their core, all historical revolutions center on trials. A nation's rulers are all tried and held accountable for their crimes. But you saw the horrendous trial that took place last night. Nobody cares about due process when emotions are running high. Regardless of the outcome of the revolution, we need to make sure that everybody has an equal opportunity for justice.
That makes sense. So what's the plan? We head to Quesnel's tavern and hand out some business cards?
Think bigger. Who will the rebels target?
The king?
Exactly. To the police royale!
We fly into the sun. Act 4B. Egalité. La 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 la. Falcon and Sparrowson rush to the Palais Royal to arrange a private audience with the king. Is that just a thing you can do? After filing a pile of forms, the two are led to a waiting area. Oh, hey, you. Oh, yeah.
No, they don't know about him yet.
No. I don't remember what voice I did for him.
He was just real nervous.
Are you here to see the king?
That's right.
Okay, take a number and wait to be called.
Yeah, it was about like that. Take a number?
Yep, just wait your turn.
Alright, bye. More fools who have come to see the king. Let me guess. Lawyers. I don't know what this voice
is. It's fine.
That's right. How did you...
Hey, I know you. You're the Prime Minister. Monsieur Gazot. Gazot? Probably Gazot.
Yeah.
Gazot?
Oh, wow. You're right, Sparrowson. It's an honor to meet you, Prime Minister. Spare the formalities. You two are here to offer the King legal aid, aren't you?
Yep, we're going to offer him assistance for the upcoming rebellion.
Let me give you a word of advice. Don't bother.
You have yet to see how persuasive Falcon is.
Mm-hmm. Excuse me? The king doesn't take kindly to any form of criticism. He buries his head so far in the sand that one could swear he's an ostrich.
Huh.
One would think that 7 assassination attempts would be enough for the man to learn he is detested.
Oh.
With all due respect, Prime Minister, I think the King of France is mature enough not to let his ego get in the way of his senses. Whoa, Falcon. So one would think.
So maybe he's not a bad guy, and the king is. Interesting. We'll see. Oh. The nervous guy yelled 24.
It was a pleasure meeting you, Monsieur. Good luck. You'll need it. I hope I don't have to do him later.
24! Call in number 24!
Good day, Your Majesty. Good day, Messieurs! Can I help you with something? Oh, I probably should have prepared a speech beforehand. That would have been smart, huh?
Just wing it. Because they're birds.
Right, let's see. How to start. Anything. It says pick anything.
Listen up.
Listen up, Your Majesty. We got important matters to discuss, and we don't have time for any back talk. How rude. Is this a way to speak to your king? Shit's about to go down, yo.
Does it say pick anything?
It literally says any option.
For both of these?
Well, it just says, talk with Louis Felipe, any option.
Okay.
Across the whole city, everyone of every class is getting angry. Merde's about to go down, yo.
I like this.
Such vile language! Maybe don't say for a price.
I think we should switch it up now and be like, so, we humbly offer our aid.
Yeah, shit's about to go down. We are sure that such a pitiful revolt will blow over in no time at all. Nonetheless, we'd like to humbly offer our aid as lawyers. We may be of great use to the throne in this troublesome time.
He's like, you two just completely switched personalities.
I think I understand. You do? I understand that you are a perv con artist attempting to screw a self-made bourgeois out of his hard-earned cash.
We didn't even say there was a price, bruh.
You have some nerve to even imply that my people hate me. I am the citizen king. I am beloved by all.
Beloved kings tend to experience fewer assassination attempts.
Kimchi, you're like kicking the table, and I need you to stop. Beck, have these two crooks thrown in jail. Maybe that will teach them a thing or two about respect.
Right away, your majesty.
You can't be serious. He's serious.
Oh,
he was serious.
That seems like something Pharaohson would say. Well, this is another fine mess you've gotten me into.
There's no need for the attitude, Pharaohson. We won't be in here for long. Once we receive a court hearing, the judges will no doubt dismiss our charges instantly. Except the king did it.
And how long will it take for us to get a court hearing? Tell me that, Monsieur Smarty Pants.
She's like, what are you doing? A week or so, I'm guessing? I can see why that might be a problem. The revolution could be in full swing by then. What to do?
Where's Coco Rico? We could try escaping.
Don't be ridiculous. Nobody has ever escaped from the conciergerie before.
Don't forget, Sparrowson does some ridiculous, conniving little things. But nobody has ever locked the genius Sparrowson and his witty lackey Falcon into the same jail cell before.
An absurd suggestion.
You got any better ideas?
Okay, let's break out of prison.
Fantastic!
Examine things!
What are my options? Up there, hello fridge, over there, that, and this.
A fireplace. It's been bricked up, so escaping up the chimney isn't an option. Why is there... Well, okay, never mind.
Maybe they converted something.
Yeah.
A ledge! Give me a leg up, and I can grab on and shimmy my way over somewhere.
To be honest, Pharaohson, neither of us had the physical prowess to shimmy anywhere. I want to say the door and then the thing next to the door.
Those are the last. Those are the only two, right? Okay.
Yeah.
There's a little dent here. One of us could hide.
Hide? What would that accomplish?
Well, a guard would eventually come in and be like, where's the other prisoner? And we use the momentary confusion to push him over and escape.
Do you really think an experienced guard would be confused by a prisoner hiding in a little hole in the wall? We can do better.
Look, Falcon, a loose brick. We could wait for a guard to transfer us to some place, sneak up behind him, and then...
And then we get a death sentence for murder. I think not. Let's search a little harder.
What am I missing? Okay. There's a bit of scrap metal inside this hole. I think it broke off an iron shackle. We could dig through the stone walls with this. See? It's all scratchy.
That may actually work if we had a decade or two.
So that's a maybe on the stone digging scheme.
Well, I'll keep it in mind in case the king decides to go all Count of Monte Cristo on us.
I don't remember that story. Okay, so there's gonna be more.
He was like left in jail for years and years and years. It just says investigate the jail.
I'm investigating.
Yeah, it doesn't really say anything else. I mean, if there's nothing else, we may have a discussion, and then they may just come let us out.
Oh, yeah. Oh, right. It's not just gonna go away.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys, I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything. Nope, not missing anything.
I give up.
So soon?
Yes, trying to escape from a notoriously inescapable prison wasn't the smartest plan we've ever devised. Well, well, well. I think that's Quark. That voice, that condescending tone.
It's Cocorico.
Or it's Cocorico. Yeah. Oh, it is
Cocorico. Cocorico!
Just what are you two bird brains doing?
Severin, are you all right?
Yes, yes, I'm fine. The injuries I sustained were mostly superficial. The doctor advised me not to do anything strenuous anytime soon, but he gave the all clear for returning to my job. So tell me, why did I get a memo informing me that J.J. Falcon and Sparrowstone were being held in the conciergerie for treason? It's Falcon's fault! Naturally.
I figure that if a revolution was inevitable, then we should do our best to ensure the uprising proceeds in an organized manner. The less bloodshed, the better.
Okay, so what did you do?
We offered the king our assistance. We said we would defend him in court, and if and when such a need arises.
Well, we didn't quite use those words.
This isn't the first time the king has had someone imprisoned for something so pointless. What a pig-headed fool. Consider your charges dropped.
All right, let's get out of here.
Hold on. You've caught my interest with this idea of yours. A bloodless revolution. You are absolutely right in that if the king is captured, the citizens will devolve into an unruly mob of animals. We should prepare a formal trial. No, we should preempt it.
We? You're gonna help us?
Of course. This isn't a task that can be handled by two birds alone.
What do you mean by preempt, Severin?
We go on the offensive. We charge the king with crimes against the French people before the rebels can even act.
We can do that?
We can certainly try. I'll start building a case against the king. My argument will be focused on the king's gluttonous and irreverent fiscal policies, his lack of commitment to his socio-political promises, his overall ineptitude and irresponsibility on all facets of his duties as a monarchical ruler, and obviously his denial of universal suffrage.
What is suffrage? I thought that was the right to vote.
Yeah.
Okay. Obviously.
How am I supposed to defend the king from all that?
You can't. If you try to argue with logic and facts, this hypothetical trial will inevitably result in a landslide guilty verdict. So I suggest that you take a different approach. Appeal to the king's character.
Mm-hmm.
Try to win people's hearts with tales of the beloved Citizen King.
He hasn't been called the Citizen King for like 10 years?
It was just a suggestion. But consider this, you don't need to win the case. You just need to make a strong enough argument that the trial is fair. All that remains is ensuring that the king can be peacefully brought to the courthouse when the protests start to turn violent. That's a job for the police and the royal guard. I'll inform Inspector Valerity of our plan so that he can prepare accordingly. At least, I would if I could find him.
Inspector Valerity is missing?
Apparently. He's taken an informal leave of absence since Wednesday.
Is he still doing that freaking Viridian killer shit?
Who knows? Well, he doesn't know the truth yet in this arc, so...
He didn't even find out the truth in the other
arc. No, he didn't. Well, we can only assume that maybe he actually went to go find out about it.
Yeah.
Because of what Falcon told him.
Hold on, Falcon. One thing eludes me. As you probably figured, Inspector Valerity had me perform an investigation into your past. He thought you were the Viridian killer, crazy as it sounds. And well, I'm sorry for doing that. It was quite invasive of me, but I can't help but wonder. Why did you change your name around 1830?
Because I was ashamed, I suppose.
They just really gonna tell us without any...
No, it doesn't tell you till later.
Okay.
I had a family to live up to. My grandfather was something of a successful lawyer. So when I turned up to my classes at law school, people would gawp at me. They would say, "Wow, you have big shoes to fill," and your grandfather would be proud.
Ugh, that does sound annoying.
But I was a terrible law student, mediocre at best. I knew that, deep down, I would never be half the man my grandfather was.
Fascinating. I had no idea. Who was your grandfather, if you don't mind me asking, Falcon?
It doesn't matter. At the end of the day, he was just an overly opinionated rebel who died in the old revolution.
I see. Well, let's not dilly-dally any longer. We have duties to carry out.
Right. We're going to find anecdotes, and we're going to defend the king, whether he likes it or not.
You find out later who his grandfather was.
I figured.
That's like later in the trial, I think.
Alrighty, okay. So where are we gonna go?
You have to visit 6 locations in any order and gather evidence for the trial.
Oh, alright then.
So if you want to do it in the order it says here.
Sure, why
you're
not?
You're already on the bibliothèque, so go to the bibliothèque.
That's funny, that's actually what I was gonna say I wanted to go first, because I like the donkey.
You like Nathan?
I do, I like Nathan.
Okay, here we go. Nathan would never let us down for useful information. I'm sure he's got something interesting and pleasant to say about the king.
Nobody's gonna have anything good to
say. He doesn't have anything pleasant to say about anything!
I know, right? He's such a grump. Oh, it's you, messieurs. Perhaps you will surprise me today and actually ask to take out a book. Nope, just the usual today, an endless stream of questions. You two need an encyclopedia. Well, go on then. Ask whatever drivel you want to ask. Does it say what I ask, or just both of them?
Just talk to Nathan.
Okay.
From your well-educated standpoint, is King Louis Philippe a good leader, as far as leaders go?
Well, I can't fault the king's pro-business spirit. The big industry leaders love him. Oh, that sounds promising. Of course, this comes at the expense of everyone who isn't bourgeois. The wealth divide is stronger than ever. Maybe not. You can forget about socially progressive policies. The king signs off on all of Guizot's backwards thinking policies, so they're both assholes. And of course, in terms of leadership and charisma, the king is about as personable as a rotten pear. So apparently making him a chipper-friendly guy was the wrong thing to do.
Yeah. Well, because he acts like a chipper-friendly guy.
Yeah, well, he did in the trial. He seems like a completely different character from when he was at the trial. You know?
So, the way he was rocking back and forth, he just seems, like, in his own little world. Like,
I
he's
thought
just
he was supposed to be in a rocking chair.
Yeah, but he just seems kind of like a silly person.
Yeah.
To me, like, he's just totally, like, he's in denial.
Yeah.
He's like, no, everything is wonderful. I am beloved by my subjects.
Yeah.
They'll do, Monsieur. A simple no would have sufficed.
No, I wouldn't have. We need details, Falcon.
Yeah.
Fuck off.
Have you ever met him? Stop. Have you ever met him?
As a matter of fact, I have, as a matter of fact. He occasionally drops by this library to check out books. Unlike some people.
What sort of books does he check out, Monsieur?
Thick books. I believe the last one he checked out was an expansive history of the Macedonian Empire.
See, that's the thing. Like, he reads such big stuff, but he doesn't act like he's very educated. Well, not that he's not. Well, yeah, he acts kind of, like, childish.
Yeah.
I had no idea that His Majesty was interested in academic history.
I'll make a note. King Louis Philippe is well-read and intelligent man. It must be said that the books are usually returned with footprints on the covers. That leads me to believe that the king may just stand on them during his speeches.
Oh.
Well, let's leave that part out. Nathan's story has been added to your evidence folder. Was there anything else?
That'll be all. Thank you for your time and patience, Monsieur.
I look forward to your next round of idiotic questions. I really do.
Aww.
He's my favorite. Aside from Renard, Nathan's my favorite.
Travel to Pont d'Arts and talk with Toussaint.
Toussaint. Which one is Toussaint? Oh, the kingfisher.
Monsieur Kingly, we need your help.
He was southern too, but I don't really want to do a southern voice anymore.
He was just real fidgety, and he's like, don't call me kingfisher. Yeah. Or don't call me fisherman.
Finally, it's about time someone around here appreciated my skills. Your fishing skills, right? The term is angling, wise guy.
This has nothing to do with fishing, so let me cut the preamble. We're looking for people who have positive stories about the king. Would you happen to have any?
Stories, huh? You came to the right guy. I have a whale of a story for you. The other day, I was fishing, and I caught a monster of a catfish. It was 2 meters long, easily. Here we go. I caught a fish, and it was this big. Oh, sure, I drag a 90-kilogram falcon out of the water and everyone buys it. But I claim to catch one big fish and suddenly everyone's skeptic.
Please continue your story, Monsieur Kingly.
Oh, right. So anyway, the king of all people happened to be walking by with his entourage, and they all clapped and cheered and came over to see the fish. And then the king says, I'm hungry. Let's cook this fellow up. And then he just walks off with my fish. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can believe that. It seems like something a royal penguin would do.
Did you at least get paid for your fish? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. One of the royal guards was nice enough to flip one franc my way. One franc! He may as well just flip me the bird. No offense. Aha! So the king supports the local fishing industry. I'm writing this down.
Oops.
Toussaint's story has been added to your evidence folder.
I have no idea if this story will be of any use to us, but we appreciate your time, Monsieur. Good day to you.
Bye, Monsieur Fisherman. Hey, don't call me a fisherman!
Guess where we're going next?
You can tell me in the next episode.
Ooh,
mysteries. But I'm gonna guess that we're gonna go see Renard.
Yeah.
Alright, we're gonna go see Renard in the next episode. So we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey everybody, this is J2A. We just want to say thanks for watching our video.
We appreciate any and all support we get from viewers, new and returning.
If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel.
Thanks again, and we'll catch you guys next time.
Bye. Bye.